In this video, I'm going to show you how to create captions, add validation rules, and use the Lookup wizard. So let's go ahead and open up our donations table here, and let's take a look at some of the field names. We can select all the rows and then double click, just like in Excel, to set it to best fit so we can see it. Now, reading camel case is not very easy for everyone, so we can use a caption to make it more user friendly. Not only here in the table, but when we create a query from this database, also the caption name will be pulled into the query instead of the field name. So let's go into design view and let's add a caption. So we do that down here in the field properties. We're just going to use donation date as our caption. And we're actually going to set the default value here as well. We're going to use a built-in function in Access, similar to the built-in function in Excel. Now, and you'll notice that you need to open and close brackets. It does not take any parameters. So the donation date, setting it to now, means that when you save and go to add in a new donation, you'll see today's date and the time will be set in here. So let's go back into design view and add a few more captions. Let's add one for the donation amount. Watch your spelling. There's no spell check here. Donation amount. And then we will save and close this table and go into the donors table in design view. So right click into design view. Let's create a lookup here. So we have a few options. So if we look at our data in data sheet view, we'll see that there's a few fields that are yes and no fields here. So instead of typing yes and no, it'd be nice to have a drop down. Or alternatively, we can let the user type yes and no, but only yes and no. So we can restrict the data. We do that again in design view under the field properties for that specific field. So we have both the e-newsletter field that's yes and no, and same with the volunteer. So let's do the validation rule here for the e-newsletter. So we're going to make it equal to, in quotes, yes or no. So the field has to say either yes or no. And the validation text basically lets the person inputting data into this database know what the validation rule is. So enter either yes or no. When we save this, and then get a message saying that you've changed the field properties, this may affect your data. In this case, it shouldn't, unless you've modified one of these fields. When we go down now to create a new donation, so go to the end, blank new, and we click here. If we try and type something like maybe, we'll get an error. The error message that we wrote, enter either yes or no. So if I enter yes, then I do not get an error message. You'll notice that this is not case sensitive, so that's really handy as well. The other thing that we can do that I'll show you for the volunteer is to create a drop down, what we call in Access lookup. If you get an error message like this that says there's no valid data, escape is the way to clear that, and then you should be able to go back into design view. Now we're going to select the volunteer data type, and we're going to change the data type to use the lookup wizard. And often you can do this to connect the primary and foreign keys, creating a relationship, and thereby pulling in not only the ID number, but also the name of the donor, for example. But in this case, we're going to type in the values that we want, simply because the values are only yes and no. So we have yes and no. Those are our two options for this field. Either they're volunteering or they're not. So yes, we're going to just leave the label volunteer. That's fine. And we're going to limit it to this list. So it has to be either yes or no. We do not allow multiple values, and click finish. So again, we save this and go into data sheet view, clicking on the new blank record at the bottom. We now have the option to use a drop down, yes or no. And again, we could type it, maybe give us a little bit of an error or autocorrect to the most appropriate option. The very last thing we're going to look at is the required field. So let's go ahead and close the table. If you get that error message again, remember, says it couldn't save it, so it gave me an out, but escape on your keyboard is also a way to clear a field if you're just testing your data.